Dear students, look at this scale. I am considering this as solid bar. We are heating the solid bar from one end. By the matter of time, scale will be heated from one end to the other end. That means from hot end to the cold end. Consider a solid bar of uniform cross section such that it is heated at one end continuously. Heat is transferred along the length of the solid bar over the time. Now, consider the two planes P1 and P2 at distances x and x plus dx from the hot end. Now, look at the diagram. Solid bar is heated at the left end of the solid bar. I am considering left end of the solid bar as x is equal to 0 and right end as x is equal to L. That means solid bar has a length L. Now, I am considering plane P1 perpendicular to the solid bar at the distance x from the left end of the bar. Again, I am considering another plane P2 which is parallel to P1 which is at a distance x plus dx from the left end of the bar. Also, the temperature at plane P1 is theta and temperature at plane P2 is theta plus d theta, or it can be written as theta plus d theta by dx into dx, such that the difference between plane P1 and P2 is dx, which is the length between P1 and P2. Hence, Q1 amount of heat is flow through plane P1 and heat flow through plane P2 is Q2. Now, we can say the temperature gradient at the plane P1 is d theta by dx. Here the theta is excess of temperature, which is above the surroundings of the solid bar at P1. The excess of temperature at P2 is theta plus d theta, or it can be written as theta plus d theta by dx into dx. The temperature gradient at P2, similarly, it can be written as d by dx of theta plus d theta by dx into dx. Now, using the definition of thermal conductivity, we can write the amount of heat that flows through P1 in 1 second. It is Q1 is equal to minus Ka d theta by dx, where we have neglected T, that means T is equal to 1 second. Similarly, we can write amount of heat that flows through P2 in 1 second as Q2 is equal to minus Ka into d by dx of theta plus d theta by dx into dx. Therefore, heat gained per second by the solid bar between the planes P1 and P2 is given by Q. It is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Now, substituting Q1 and Q2 from the above equations, we can write it is equal to minus Ka d theta by dx. Minus into minus becomes plus Ka d by dx of theta plus d theta by dx into dx. If we multiply the second term, Ka d by dx theta plus Ka d theta by dx into dx. Now, minus Ka d theta by dx plus Ka d theta by dx cancel each other. We will be left with the Ka d square theta by dx square into dx. This is the amount of heat flowing through a bar per second. Now, we will employ a specific condition. That means, before the steady state is reached, a part of heat is used to increase the temperature of the section and the rest is lost due to radiation. Steady state means the temperature is uniform along the bar over the time. Whenever we heat a solid bar, some amount of heat will be lost through a radiation process. Let the rate of rise of temperature of the bar be d theta by dt. That means it is the ratio of change in temperature with respect to the time. Now we will write amount of heat used per second to raise the temperature of the bar, which is given by mass into specific heat into rise in temperature. Mass can be written as A dx into rho. This is by using the definition of density. Density is equal to mass by volume. That means rho is equal to mass divided by volume. Volume is equal to A into dx. Here specific heat is S and rise in temperature is d theta by dt. Now we can write an equation for amount of heat lost per second due to radiation. That is equal to E into P into dx into theta, where E is the emissive power of the surface. That means it gives the capacity of a solid bar surface to emit a radiation, and P is that sectional parameter and theta is the excessive temperature over the surrounding. Now, by using equation number 3 and equation number 4, 5, we can write amount of heat which passes through planes P1 and P2 as ADX rho S d theta by dt plus EP dx theta. Now, substituting for Q from equation 3, that is KA d square theta by dx square into dx on the left hand side of the equation number 6. Now, divide the whole equation by K into A. We will get d square theta by dx square because KA will be cancelled out. Dx is in the all the parts of equation. That means it will be cancelled out. Right hand side will be left with rho S divided by K, where AA gets cancels d theta by dt plus EP divided by KA into theta. This is the standard Fourier equation for one-dimensional heat flow along a length of a solid bar.